one more time.
For only the second time, by the way.
What a match that was 8 years ago. They still talk about it. Warrior won the first contest. Hogan wants revenge. He'll get his shot in Vegas on October 25th on pay-per-view.
Is it a case of Hogan wanting revenge, or is it a case of the Warriors' mind games tearing apart at Hogan and getting under his skin so much that he finally put in the challenge to the Warrior? I mean, what took them nearly 8 years between matches? I think that Hogan knows that the Warrior has his number.
I agree with you 100%, Mike Tenay. Hogan has only two blemishes on his record. He hasn't avenged Goldberg from last July in the Georgia Dome and the Warrior from 8 years ago. Goldberg will have to wait until at least after Halloween Havoc. Hogan wants to avenge that defeat at the hands of the Warrior. But you're right, the Warrior has gotten under his skin and into his mind.
Well, let's see if the pattern continues with another former Flock member in Horace as he squares off with Nick Dinsmore.
Horace, well, it's a new look, wearing the singlet in there, no longer wearing that standard ring attire of the Flock, the torn jeans and grunge look. Side headlock by Horace. Nick Dinsmore shoots Horace across, shoulder block by Horace.
And Nick Dinsmore is a youngster, still in his early 20s. Again, we've been impressed with Nick Dinsmore against some of the WCW cruiserweights. But in Horace, this is definitely no cruiserweight. This big man, near the 300-pound mark. Knife-edged chop. Oh, and another one just rocked Dinsmore.
Well, I'll give Dinsmore credit. This week, he has faced the Cat and Wrath, and now Horace. He is going after the top in World Championship Wrestling, trying to become a good bit better wrestler. Now, Nick Dinsmore barring the arm of Horace, working over the shoulder. And the crowd reacting to something here on Saturday night. What is going on? Oh, tell me no.
No.
Out of the corner of my eye, I hope.
Who was it?
I don't know. I'm not even going to fathom a guess. Horace, belly-to-back release, silk suplex on Nick Dinsmore.
I think that one stunned Nick. Oh, that's exactly what it was.
I knew it.
You know, if I think there's one exception to the group of Flock members that are probably going to realize much more success after leaving the Flock, it's probably this clown, Lodi.
I don't think Lodi will achieve anything close to what Horace or Riggs or Sick Boy or Kidman will achieve. I think Lodi could be very happy to be working the overnights at a Waffle House somewhere.
Nice display of agility by Horace that time, slingshotting himself over the top. Now,
look at this.
Lodi face to face with Horace.
Oh, did you hear Horace? He doesn't need the stop sign. And I assume he's going to argue with that one that says we need Raven.
Ooh. Oh, look at this coward.
Lodi, how ridiculous. Still can't cut the umbilical cord linking him to Raven. Now Nick Dinsmore opening up, but Horace fires back with a right hand. Kick right into the chest of Dinsmore. Horace shoots Dinsmore close, follows up the corner lariat. Oh.
The head of Dinsmore snapping back in the corner. There's the elbow drop.
That may very well do it. Cover, lateral press, only got the two count on Dinsmore. And Horace, I think he's still distracted by Lodi at ringside.
We see Dinsmore trying to shake the cobwebs. Almost just a natural reaction to kick out there. Oh, that'll stop him.
Oh, please. Still some of that Flock mentality left in Horace, going straight to the eyes. Shoots Dinsmore across, charges in. Horace misses with the corner splash, and Dinsmore. Grub kick, takes Horace back. Another one. Oh, and Horace is leveled on Saturday night. Dinsmore needs to fire it up if he's going to get the victory.
Well, he had the big man off of his feet momentarily. Now follows up in the corner. Couple of right hands to the top of the head. Whip the big man across. Oh! He turned his back on Horace, and that was a critical error.
That wasn't a clothesline. That was a forearm to the face. And Nick Dinsmore, I'm surprised he's not counting teeth on the floor here on Saturday night. Belly-to-back suplex by Horace. And Horace has Dinsmore. Dinsmore is staggered. He is seeing stars out there, and he's counting the lights right now as Horace goes up top. Oh!
Big splash off the top.
Oh, now what? That's enough.
Out of the full Nelson. Ooh. Big full Nelson slam.
That's got to do it. Hooks the leg, lateral press and cover in the three count. And Horace wins it. Horace with a victory on W.